Is the M4 Mac Mini worth it? After 30 days of daily use, I can tell you that without a doubt, the M4 Mac Mini is the most impressive piece of technology that Apple's released in the past decade. Full stop. But if you've been on the fence trying to figure out whether the M4 is right for you, you've come to the right place. I'm answering all of your burning questions to figure out whether or not the M4 Mac Mini is the right choice for you, including what makes it so special. So let's start with the most noticeable improvement, which is gonna be the design. Apple has significantly reduced the footprint of the M4 Mac Mini by over 40%, making it way, way smaller than the previous generation. It's small enough in size to take up very little space on your desk. It also weighs 1.2 pounds less than the previous iteration, coming in at just 1.5 pounds, allowing you to easily transport the Mac Mini from place to place. Now, the smaller chassis is paired with two USB-C ports here on the front, which are both 10 gigabits per second, and a 3.5 millimeter jack here as well, which is a first for the Mac Mini, which really allows connecting peripherals much more convenient no matter where you decide to set it up. Now, despite the reduced size, the Apple's new thermal architecture ensures that this small 5x5x2 inch box stays cool and quiet even under heavy workloads. Now, the Mac Mini is a bare bones computer, meaning that when you purchase it, all you're gonna get in the box is gonna be the Mac Mini and the power cord. You don't get a mouse, you don't get a keyboard, you don't get a monitor. So those are all things that you would need to supply yourself. Now, most videos that you watch are gonna tell you that it's gonna look great with the Studio Display, which is, it's an obvious, right? It's an Apple product. It's gonna pair very well with the Apple product. But if you're looking for the Studio Display, maybe just a little bit less costly, I would suggest checking out the Asus ProArt PA27 PCB. I'll put a link down in the description. It's essentially the same specs as the Studio Display at half the cost. I'll be making a review of that very soon. So if you wanna see that, make sure you get subscribed. But that is a great alternative to the Studio Display. Now, the compact size and miniature design are impressive, but where you really see the magic happen is gonna be all under the hood. And let's dive into performance and talk about how the M4 is a game changer for performance. The base M4 balances power and performance with 4 high performance cores for demanding tasks and 6 efficiency cores that keep everyday use both smooth and efficient. Now, if you need more power, the M4 Pro delivers extra muscle with 8 performance cores, perfect for handling larger workloads, though you do lose 2 efficiency cores in that process. On the graphics side, the base M4 comes with 10 GPU cores, while the M4 Pro raises the bar to 16, making it a great choice for graphics-intensive workflows like video editing or 3D rendering. Compared to the previous generation M2 Mac Mini, you're gonna get about 20% increase depending on how you have your M2 Mac Mini spec'd. But if you're upgrading from an older Mac, let's say maybe an Intel Mac or an M1 Mac, the leap is gonna be even more transformative, making your old device even seem more archaic. In my experience, everyday tasks like launching apps or switching between programs is incredibly snappy, but it's with heavier workloads like editing video, running AI tools, where the M4 is really gonna shine. Is it good enough for demanding tasks like professional workflows? Whether you're editing in Final Cut Pro, you're editing photos in Photoshop or Lightroom, or even rendering 3D models in Blender, the M4 holds up extremely well. Depending on how often or how frequently you're doing those things, you might want to consider the M4 Pro because of the added horsepower, but the M4 can't handle it. Now, I use the M4 Mac Mini as part of my video editing workflow. Right now, all this footage is being ingested into the Mac Mini. It's being recorded locally on that device. And really, the editing process, which includes 4K footage, color correction, graphics, adjustments, the result is that it did it all with almost zero hiccups. The fan would turn on. Sometimes it just depended on maybe if that graphic or that adjustment was not optimized for the M4, but it really is a beast and there's not much that I threw at it where I had a lot of trouble. Question 5, RAM and storage options. The base model starts at 256 gigs of internal storage and it's configurable up to 2 terabytes, while the M4 Pro comes with 512 gigs for that base configuration and it's configurable up to 8 terabytes for a pretty penny, making it perfect for anyone working with large files and large media libraries. Now, during the past month, I noticed that the SSD speeds on the M4 Pro were significantly faster by almost about 2x, depending on what you were using and what configuration that you had. But if that is something that you need high speed or high read-write speed, you want to consider the M4 Pro. Now, one of the things I didn't talk about here is that I do have this Thunderbolt 5, whoops, just smacked me in the face, this Thunderbolt 5 drive here from OWC. These are quite expensive. You could choose something like this if you wanted to expand the memory or the storage, but it's not really cost effective. I think this is like $499 for 2 terabytes. I'm checking it out right now. Don't know if I'll keep it. I actually don't know if I need it. That's probably the more important part. Now, as with previous Apple Silicon devices, What you buy when you purchase the device in terms of storage and RAM is gonna be what it's configured with. It is non-upgradable for the most part. Now, there are some people I've seen who had taken their Mac Mini apart and went through the process of adding on or replacing the internal storage. It's not for the faint-hearted. I'll put a link in the description here above if you wanna check that out, but it does void your warranty, so just know that going into it. Now, that said, I think the sweet spot for a lot of people is gonna be the M4 base model, 24 gigs of unified memory with 1 terabyte of internal storage. That seems to be a really good use, even though you are gonna pay Apple's upgrade fees for the internal storage and for the RAM. But if you're handling more intensive workflows, adding more RAM and more storage is never a bad move. What's new with the ports and wireless features? The M4 Mac Mini features Thunderbolt 4 on the base model and Thunderbolt 5 on the M4 Pro. These updates not only support faster data transfer speeds, but also enable impressive display configurations through the USB-C and HDMI ports. Both models now support native DisplayPort output, with the M4 using DisplayPort 1.4 and the M4 Pro stepping it up to DisplayPort 2.1 for even higher bandwidth. So what this means is that, practically speaking, since the M4 Pro supports DisplayPort 2.1, it's gonna be able to handle higher refresh rates, better color depth, and larger resolutions, making it a little bit more future-proof for people who have that in their workflow or who have a little bit more fluidity in their workflow. The Mac Mini also supports Wi-Fi 6E, ensuring faster, more reliable internet speeds and reduced latency for devices that are going to be connected to the 6 GHz network. In addition, it features Bluetooth 5.3, which adds stability and improved efficiency, especially for peripherals like keyboards, mouse, and wireless headphones. Now, out of the box, there's a 1 gigabit Ethernet connector that's going to be on the back of the Mac Mini. I think that one of the best upgrades that you can choose to is upgrade it to a 10 gigabit Ethernet port for $100. What this means is that it's gonna be perfect for handling large file transfers or working with network storage, a breeze if you see that as part of your use cases. Now, the standard M4 Mac Mini supports up to 2 displays, up to 6K at 60 hertz over Thunderbolt. Now, if you need more display power, the M4 Pro levels it up a notch because you can support 3 displays, up to 6K at 60 hertz over Thunderbolt. This means whether you're working with multiple high resolution monitors for productivity or using an ultra wide for gaming, the M4 gives you the flexibility that you're gonna need for the perfect setup. Now, without a doubt, the M4 Mac Mini's connectivity options are incredibly versatile, but how does it hold up in real world usage? Let's talk about that next. The base model Mac Mini comes with 256 gigs of internal storage and 16 gigs of unified memory. Now, for most casual users who are handling tasks like web browsing, streaming, and light productivity, this configuration is more than capable. However, if you are working with larger files, maybe video editing or multitasking with multiple demanding apps, maybe you have like 30 Chrome tabs open, I don't know, some people do it, I would suggest upgrading to more RAM, maybe going to 24 or maybe probably even 32 if you're a heavy Chrome user, because you can have a lot of tabs open. It just seems to be that way. Now, the next question I get is, how does the Mac Mini compare against the Mac Studio or even the iMac? Well, if you need expandability, if you need better GPU performance, even though there's not an M4 Mac Studio today, the Mac Studio is gonna be a better performer for you. On the other hand, the iMac, which is an all-in-one solution, is gonna be great because it is an all-in-one solution. You really just have kind of one point of failure. One, it's gonna be limited size. Two, you're not gonna get the power out of the iMac compared to the Mac Mini. And if you already have the peripherals, keyboard, mouse, display, and you want portability, the Mac Mini is the option for you. Now, when we talk about the Mac Mini, the next relevant question is gonna be, how does the Mac Mini perform with gaming? Well, the M4 Mac Mini has a 10-core GPU and the 16-core option on the M4 Pro. It delivers solid performance for gaming, especially for titles that are optimized for the Mac. Now, that said, macOS still does not have the gaming libraries that Windows have, so this is your primary use case. You already know that. But what if you are a professional where you do maybe photo editing, you do some type of motion graphics? The M4 Mac Mini is gonna be able, I think it's gonna rival a lot of the other options that are on the market today in such a small form factor. But that doesn't make it perfect. There are still some limitations of the M4 Mac Mini. Even with these 3 Thunderbolt 4 or Thunderbolt 5 ports on the back, there are still limited connectivity options where you might need to either import media, you might need more than just these 3, and where you would need to connect it to a hub or a dock. Now, I do have the OWC Thunderbolt 5 hub coming very shortly, and if you wanna see that, make sure you get subscribed, because that will actually open up a lot of options for anyone who needs, you know, more than 3 displays, more than you need to connect multiple drives, multiple peripherals to your device. So make sure you get subscribed. Let's tackle the ultimate question: is it worth upgrading and who should consider it? Now, if you're coming from an older Intel-based Mac Mini or even the M1, the M4 Mac Mini is a no-brainer. This leap in performance, efficiency, and connectivity is gonna be huge for your workflows. It really makes upgrading feel like a completely new experience on macOS. But if you're coming from an M2 Mac Mini, I think the justification is a little bit harder to make, and it's a little bit softer in terms of like what you actually need. You would have to need Thunderbolt 5 for the faster throughput. You would need higher resolution displays or even more GPU processing power that you have on your M2 Mac Mini. But for anyone new to the Mac ecosystem as a whole or replacing like an aging Windows desktop, the Mac Mini is a great starting point. It blends power performance and versatility, really making it a triple threat and an entry point into the Apple ecosystem. But I wanna know what you think. Are you considering getting the M4 Mac Mini? Let me know down in the comments below which configuration you're gonna get. If I didn't cover your question, put that down below and I'll help you out, figure out which Mac Mini is gonna be best for you by answering your question. My name is Mike. If you enjoyed today's video, consider hitting like. If you wanna see more content like this, hit subscribe. It does really help the channel out. I would appreciate it. Guys, happy holidays, and I'll talk to you in the next one.